Roberts is in position, taps it down, right over there towards O'Connell, who gets a short kick in towards Jesilinko, and Pyle is the call. It goes to Sheedy. Sheedy gets it over here towards Parker. Parker's long kick goes around the grandstand side, knocked away, and moving in hard as Wood for Richmond. His handball is astray, goes towards Ray. He was tackled, dropped it. A handball here back to Barton for his second kick. If he gets it, he's pushed from behind, and Pyle is the call. And by gee, what an opening for Jim.
A great opening, and Bartlett receiving heavy treatment there. Ian Robertson right on the ball here. The free kick will go to Wayne Walsh. He's kicking from the half-forward flank right in front of the members stand here at the MCG, and a good long kick. It's offline, and a shocker. Kick taken by Byrne, kicked right into Ray again, who's messing around with the trainer there. Missed the flight of the ball. Stewart's in there, overruns it, back to Robert Walls. Robert Walls' kick, a snap one out here towards Cotaggio, but it's way offline, over the line for a throw-in.
Roberts gets a tap down, goes out here towards Jesilinko with the ball, a hurried kick straight to the centre of the field, and Dick Clay with pace personified. One bounce, and look at this boy go, and a long kick, oh, it's dropping short right into the hands of Finn Waite of Carlton at centre halfback. Finn Waite playing in the back pocket, takes the mark and puts Carlton back into attack once more, dropping short. Bartlett's there, got his hands to drop it, recovers, swings onto his left boot, puts it up forward, looking for big Neil Baum, who flies. Good defensive football by Carlton as the ball goes over the boundary line for a throw-in. We've been playing 3 minutes, no score on the board as yet.
Throw-in now, still in Richmond's forward pocket. They've had the run of the ball at this stage, but not able to set up a chain reaction there as they hit out by Jones, gets it again, puts the boot to it, out deep to the flank, racing for it, Wood. Chance over, runs it. Tapped back again by Sproul, picked up by Gary Crane. Gary Crane's kick finds the centre wing. Oh, could have been a free kick against Jesilinko. He plays on now. Look at him go. A long kick into what? Nichols. Nichols.
Oh, free kick.
Free kick. Point. And Nichols is down, is it?
Yes.
Nichols free down. Kick. Very heavily met there by Dick Clay. And umpire Robertson, no doubt, said you think he'll play a free kick here.
Oh, there's no doubt he has to play the free kick. But the moment Nick went down, I watched the umpire, he blew the whistle, and he no doubt will take the free kick. John Nichols looking for a towel.
Where's it? Couldn't it have almost been a 15-yard penalty? I thought he'd taken the mark first. I thought he was hit after he'd actually taken the mark.
He's given him 15-yard penalty or 15-metre penalty, and Big Nick looks a little groggy. And I tell you what, it'll take a pretty hard bump to make him groggy.
Well, Tim, I meant to mention this before the game started. There's not anybody has tried the big fella up until now, and that was a fair dinkum try. And it looks as if there's going to be no holds barred here.
Okay, now Big John is only 20 metres out from goal, directly in front. Steadies on its way. He steered at it. The first goal of the game to Carlton, kicked by their captain and coach, Ian John Nichols. The scoreboard, Carlton. Goal with Richmond yet to score, and we'll be playing 5 minutes.
Already a sensational incident. Bounce pushed out deep towards the wing where Gary Crane races for it. Chance for Walsh. Walsh getting to the front and breaking away with pace. A good kick into the flank and found young
Stephen Carter.
Carter it is, yes, the new boy Carter, and he's got a shot for goal now from about 40 metres out on an angle.
Look at Sheedy on his own.
Short one, and Sheedy slipped but took the mark. Good play there by the young boy Carter, and it's now about a 25 metre shot at goal. Sheedy squaring up to goal now. It's not an easy shot, but it's well within his capabilities. Drop punt, slightly short, right on the line.
Oh, what's it going to go?
As it's through, and it's goal, and it's two straight goals. And he'll take this kick from centre wing. Look to play on, but
Francis Burke's in trouble. Francis Burke's in trouble as play goes on. And up to the half forward line it goes. Back to Bartlett. And the umpire's found a free kick here to Richmond. And it's gone. There's Francis
Michael
Burke.
Green.
You can see him there limping very badly as the kick by Green goes up towards Royce Hart. And Hart has marked that centre field. Burke could be in trouble for Richmond. By gee, he's a valuable player. As the umpire has given a 15-metre penalty here against Robert Walls of Carlton and Royce Hart, the Richmond captain, to take the kick.
His first kick of the game, too, and placed neatly out onto the flank. Sheedy sprinting for it, couldn't quite make it. Pennell races into the ball, dragged around the neck, and an obvious free kick will go to...
Oh! Down the... Oh!
think we're in the right posse here, but
now the umpire could get this the other way. He's paid to give it the other way. Tahiti against Big Waite.
Good big punch by Waite. Down it comes. Southby lost it. Scrambling play. Stacks on the bill. The umpire will move in and bounce this. Well in Richmond's forward line. In fact, they've had the advantage in this 13 minutes of play.
I thought there could have been a free kick to Bartlett there, Butch.
Could easily have been in. They go. Wrestling around. Chance for Jones. Lost it again. He's not timing it well. Has a hand pass out here. Racing for it. Walsh. Walsh in front. Tackled solidly. It's down again to Carter. Carter's hand pass is a bit wild. Oh, over towards Farm. And
free kick.
Trouble here.
Sheedy
to get the free. Sheedy's a bit of a thorn in their side here, moving around this forward line. And pretty hard to pick up, too.
Around the shoulder, he paid that free kick to Kevin Sheedy. Looks good, too. Both kicked by Kevin Sheedy. Let's look at the scoreboard now. Richmond, two goals, one leading Carlton, one straight goal.
In they go. Up goes Michael Green, a beauty. Down a hard, a left foot shot. It's going to be one more point to Richmond.
Out here towards Sheedy. He's kicked two, and that looks like his third. Three goals kicked by Kevin Sheedy in the first quarter. And umpire there pulls rail. The scoreboard now, Richmond, three goals, 2:20 to Carlton, 1:17.
Back into the centre for the bounce again. This is a good lead now. 3-2 to 1-1. Hit out. Out here towards Jezelenko. Jezelenko plays on quickly up towards Frank Davis. But over the top play. Down to Robert Walls. Down to Nichols. Free kick here.
Yes.
Free kick to Robert Walls.
He was held. Butch Walls not in possession and also pushed in the back. Did you pick that, Wes?
I thought so, Ted.
Drop punt. Looks deep. It's short. Just a fraction short and offline. 1 point and touch is the goal umpire. And a bad miss. That brings Carlton to 1-2, Richmond 3-2. Punched away by Burke. Stewart punches. Back to Mackay. Mackay's long shot. And it looks good.
He's
put
a goal to Carlton. Richmond, three goals, two. Carlton, two goals, two. 6 points the difference. Green's there. He missed the mark. It goes to Ray of Richmond onto his right boot. Out looking for Sheedy. It was a missed kick, but it came up. And Sheedy has taken a mark. He'll play on here with a long handball to Sproul. He's put him under the hammer. A hurried kick by Sproul. Up to the goal square. Is it going to be a goal? No. It's offline. And gone through for 1 point. Siren.
Pass and the siren sounds. Stopping play for the first quarter.
Yes, the end of the first quarter here at the MCG in the grand final between Carlton and Richmond. The scoreboard, Richmond, 3 goals, 5, 23. Lead Carlton, 2 goals, 2, 24. The quarter time scores, you're watching the grand final live from the MCG. They do battle in the air, knocked out here towards Stewart, who gets his kick, and Kevin Hall flies high and got two grabs at it. The umpire has paid the mark for a smack in the mouth. He didn't pay the mark.
Free kick.
He paid the free kick.
I was going to say, this is going to be an umpire's game the way it's going. He'd be a good 55 to 60 metres out. Good punt kick. It's curling in. Oh, is it through?
Yes. A nice goal kicked by Kevin Hall.
To Wes. The big high kick up here towards full court. Nichols was a
free
chance
kick.
To get the free kick. He was held on to. The umpire saw it clearly. And now Nichols has a chance to bring Carlton closer to Richmond. They're trailing by 9 points. 6.5 minutes into the second quarter. And Big John, 317 league games today, comes up and does not miss too many of these. Oh, it's wide. And only 1 point, 8 points the difference now, Ted.
Looking for Mackay, he's there and he has marked. David Mackay on the half forward line now, some 40 metres out from goal. A goal here to Mackay will put them well within striking distance of Richmond, who are only 8 points in front at this stage. Mackay steadies. The torpedo punt kick on its way. The goal umpire likes the look of it. So do the players. It's another one to Carlton. Kicked by David Mackay. And that's his second goal.
Head pass to Carter. Carter. And goal. And
yes.
Free minute, kick. The umpire.
Yes. Clear. All clear. All clear. Another goal to Richmond. Kicked by young Carter. And the scoreboard now. Richmond 5 goals, 5. To Carlton, 4 goals, 3. Wes, you had a good look at that incident?
Yeah, well, I thought Croswell was perhaps a bit unlucky not to get a free kick on that occasion, but nevertheless, it's
what
a goal.
For?
Well, I thought he got the backhander on the way through, Ted.
To the half-forward line where Robert Walls comes out, grabs the ball, Hal, pulled to the ground, he said he was held too high. Oh, there's another stupid free kick given away by Wayne Walsh of, hello, and there's Croswell being thrown to the deck here by Robbie McGee as umpire Ian Robinson will pay That was Kevin Hall, not Croswell.
That'll be a 30-yard penalty now.
Have a look at that, will you? That puts him well within kicking distance. He's given him two 15-yard penalties, or 15-metre penalties, as Walls now, his kick is a bad one, dropping short, and Nellie Amar to Dixon, he's paid it. Well, would you have paid that?
Well, I don't know. I think that this the umpire is just a very obvious now. The Richmond are playing more the man than the ball. And Dixon now has a good shot at goal. That's a short one, and it's got right through for 4 points. And that's an interesting stage of the game at the 10-minute mark of the second quarter. Carter now, young player. Good long kick, beautiful kick, right up here towards full forward. No mark from Roberts. Down to Sheedy. Sheedy over to Sheedy, I should say. And he scrambled and it goes.
Oh, no doubt about it. It's a great effort to get through on that occasion. And incidentally, it's interesting that the game hasn't settled down. It's still very tense.
That's right.
That's right from the start.
Farm in front, no mark, down to the ground. Oh, free kick to Southbier. Look at them going in now. Southbier's down. And so are a few others there too. I've seen that face before somewhere too. Southbier getting up off the ground. Oh, he's down again. It looks like he's copped a nasty one, but the umpires are there. And Southbier looks real groggy. Number 20, the fullback for Carlton. In the hands of the trainers, the umpires are there. If he can't take his kick, he must handball it to some teammate, or the umpire has no other alternative other than to bounce it. He looks like he may do this if Southbier can't take the kick. No, he looks okay to take it. And he looks very, very groggy indeed.
Took a while to steady himself up there. Good, sensible approach to that. Southbier kicks a poor one, and he's still groggy. Up they go, Jones and Green. Down to Bartlett. Bartlett dragged to the ground. This is going to get a very, very hard game. There it is, down. A chance there for Barn. Couldn't quite get it. Oh, he looks around again. And another Carlton player bit the dust. Oh. And a bit more wrestling.
Gee whiz, I think it's a reportable one, this one, from the
Could be.
I think the umpire copped a smack in the mouth there.
Whiz.
Sheedy talking to Neil Barn now, trying to steady this down.
This could upset the Tiger camp.
High kick, and all the little fellas there, but Roysart chipped in. O'Connell batted it down, and Francis Burke picks it. Rams it back hard towards Neil Baum and Southbie. Baum drops it, recovers, hand passes, chance for Sheedy. Sheedy ducking and dodging. Cool as you like it, it's got a goal, but he's missed it. One more point to the Tigers.
So another point on the scoreboard to Richmond, kicked by Kevin Sheedy.
Well, that is an obvious push in the back. And Sproul takes the free kick for Richmond.
Right, Sproul on centre wing now for the Tigers, telling his players to move down further. Get the long kick down. It's a nice looking kick too.
Richmond's free, who to?
In the back to Royce Hunt.
Well, he won't miss this one, I wouldn't think.
Against Peter Jones.
Highly technical stuff.
Royce Hunt now only 35 metres out from goal, with Peter Jones on the mark, and the opportunity of Richmond going further ahead here if Hunt can convert. He'll favour the drop punt. He does so. He pokes at it. It looks pretty good. The goal umpire said yes, sir. And another goal to Richmond. Umpire Ian Robertson having a good talk to the players, and the bounce takes place. Roberts is on the ball, been rather quiet for Richmond this afternoon. Knocked away by Sproul once more, but it's all Carlton. Dixon with a long handball out here to Walsh. Walsh on the half forward line, puts in a short one to Robert Walls, and he has hard in the forward pocket, the grandstand side, kicking to the scoreboard end of the MCG. There's a difference now here of, say, 30 metres from goal to Robert Walls. He pokes at it with a drop punt, but it's well offline and goes through for another point to Carlton.
Dick Clay kicking in, and it looked like a bit of blood on Southbee's ear. He got a real whack. There's a nice mark, and a hand pass from Greaves. What? Out to Walsh. Walsh from the half-back line. A long, searching kick. A chance there. Nicely punched down by Burns. Snapped up by Duell. Duell's kick into the centre of the ground finds Mackay Easy, and Carlton steadying down now. Mackay's kick is long and deep out to the flank. Jezalenko from behind, smothered. Looking for Kevin Hall. Shepherding well for Kevin Hall, and he has a shot. Chance of a mark. Chance for Sheedy. Pats it down to Southbee. Southbee loses it. Farm tries to scoop it up. Hand passes it out. Oh! Bartlett hit.
Free kick to Bartlett. Free kick. Where's Loftus? Did you pick that one up?
Oh, well, it was an obvious one, Ted, wasn't it? Just another sign of over-anxiousness.
Rich, I was sorry to interrupt your call there, but I thought you didn't see the incident. And a definite free kick to Kevin Bartlett for being hit around the neck area. 2 metres out from goal, and made no mistake about it. Another goal to Richmond, and the scoreboard now reads Richmond 7-7, leading Carlton 6-6. Two Carlton players, or young Davis in the first quarter, missed two easy shots from this distance. Let's see what experience will do as Hart shoots a goal. Dixon has the ball now, nowhere to go. Tackle, but gets his left boot to the ball out towards Walsh. The bounce is a bad one. And Bradford's in. A long kick at goal. There's nobody there but Barr. Barr onto his left boot. Goal. Beautiful goal. Kicked by Neil Barr of Richmond. And Richmond go further ahead at the 30-minute mark. The scores. Richmond, 9-8 to Carlton. 6-6. Right foot.
As he goes very high up the board. The big fellas, big Roberts in front, he's perfect.
He's
gone. I don't mean to sort of qualify my own opinion, but it's obvious that Southby is not right. Kicks, and he's...
Yes! Another one to the Tigers, kicked by the Whale, the Giant. And look at the Richmond supporters down there in the crowd. It's standing here with excitement because of the Tigers' breakaway in this second quarter.
Goes Mike Green again, rucking very well. Croswell missed the flow to the ball. Jones comes through hard. Back to Croswell. Croswell's hand pass finds Crane. Crane's kick is high into wood, centre half foot, and Mackay from behind. They both return to Jesilinko, has it? Jesilinko, hand pass here out towards Dixon. Dixon's long shot at goal. It could be! And another goal for now. Now to Green. Green plays on. Right across that half-forward line, hooking it back in towards the goal square. Big pack flies.
Free
no
kick.
Richmond mark is
free kick to Ian Stewart. Different free kick around the neck, which umpire Robinson was only standing 10 metres away. He saw it as the siren sounds to end the second quarter. Moves in on its way, a drop punt. It looks pretty good. He's popped through, and he's limping Ian Stewart, limping after that knock. And the scoreboard now at the end of the first half sees Richmond go to a score of 11-8, 74, leading Carlton 7-6, 48. It's a kick well up into the 10-yard square, looking for Michael Green and Roberts. They fly high, there's no mark. The umpire's called play on, and now he's blown the whistle. And this time he's going to award a free kick, I think, to a Richmond player. He is too, and it's going to Royce Hart. The captain of Richmond takes the free kick at the edge of the 10-yard square. Where's to see that? Right in front of goal. Moves in, shoots at goal. It looks good. It's through for another. And three goals kicked by the Richmond captain.
And the ball cleared well under centre.
Oh, wing.
Another mark to Fowler. His hand pass finds Sproul. Sproul, a long kick. And Richmond going for long kicks now. Up into the forward line. Chance there. Down under the ground. Bob snapped it over. Another hand pass to Stewart. Stewart puts it through.
Yes. Another goal. And he's in play. And that's the second goal kicked by Ian Stewart. And he has a sore leg. There's no doubt about that. The scoreboard now reads Richmond here at the MCG. 13-8, 86. Leading Carlton 7-6,
right.
48.
Shadows starting to come across the ground. It's been a perfect day, but a hard day for all players. Hot. And there's Crane in there again, being tackled, but he gets out of it again. Gee, has he got some courage, this boy. A long one into John Nichols. And down it comes. It's snipped up by Chandler into an open goal. Yes, that's the goal to Carlton at last. That's what made it.
The bounce. Big Roberts comes in with Mackay. He wins the tap down. Mackay taken away by Jesilinko. Jesilinko with a blind turn onto his left boot, looking for Robert Walls, but McGee steps in front, and McGee takes a nice mark in defence. And Pennell has a tourniquet around his knee there.
That's
trying to
cartilage,
kick the cartilage.
Sure.
There's the kick by McGee around the grandstand side. They fly in a good mark to Roberts. Handballs to Bartlett. Richmond into attack again through Bartlett. It's Big Barb and Mike Green. They fly. There's no mark. Down to Stewart. Steadies onto his left foot. And the third goal kicked by Ian Stewart. Walls, the vice-captain.
into time on.
Moves in, takes his kick. It's a drop punt. It looks good. It's swinging around. This one's okay. A goal. Leading Carlton, 9-8
by Roy Hart. A long kick now, a high one. Gives Waite the sitting shot. He punches down. Chance there for Stephen Raymond. Look at this, Walsh. A long shot. Look at it. It's a goal. Ooh. A short one in and by Jones. Now he doesn't miss too many of these. This could give him a bit of heart. Peter Jones, right on the siren. And he's kicked. 1 point.
There goes the siren now. To end the third quarter. The three-quarter time scores, Richmond 15-11-101, Carlton 9-9-63.
Up goes Jones, down it comes behind the back, picked up nicely by Quirk, hard in there, Kane, a good punch down, struggling for the ball, there is Gary Crane, picks it up, a right foot, shot at goal, at the down the centre, chance for Wood, but missed the call there. Down onto the ground, Craig Davis over to Chandler, takes it back himself again. A Richmond player down behind play. Up goes Pennell, down goes Robert Walls, and Big Roberts moved in. Messed up the hand pass. Pull back here, there's a chance. Whoa, free kick.
Carlton's way to Brian Quirk at centre half forward. Can Carlton get up now? Quirk at centre half forward. We've only been playing 5 minutes into the last quarter. The kick by Quirk will fall short. Richmond players are there. There's no mark to Walls. Step to goal. And the second goal, kicked by Robert Walls. A field not paid. And a last play. Carlton here has been played to Gary Crane. Gary Crane some 35 metres out from goal. Richmond, 4 goals in front of Carlton. Can they come back? Crane's kick is a good one. By Gary Crane.
Up they go. Another mark to Jones of Carlton. And what a wonderful comeback this is. Sheedy in there. He'll do anything to win this game. Jones out to Waite. And here's Carlton's back. Waite steps around. Through that half back line. Oh, a risky one. A hand pass down to Chandler. Bartlett moving in. Look at him go. Bartlett, round he goes.
Ian Stewart, now this is not an impossible angle, Butch, for him to kick from. He's already kicked Ronnie Wilson 3 goals for Richmond. Oh, he's on a terrible bad angle now, Stewart. Let's see what he can do with it as he moves in now. A lot of concentration. He's well over the boundary. If he kicks this, it'll be a miracle, I tell you. There it goes. He's kicked the goal and he's missed it.
High kick now by Sheedy in towards Barb. Barb's back.
This time,
but look, the Carlton players are exhausted there, and this has just been wear them down. Neil Barham now, second shot in a matter of half a minute.
Butch, since half time, Richmond have missed 8 direct shots at goal.
The most important shot.
Hasn't missed that one.
There it is.
It's the second goal kicked by Neil Barham, and another one to Richmond.
High kick into work the goal square. Up they go, Mike Green. Now to Stewart. One more point.
Sproul with the ball from centre half forward. High kick. Oh, a nice looking kick. It'll make the distance. That's on line. And goes through for another point.
Richmond Premiership. That's how they be.
The successful coach of the Premiership side for season 1973, Tommy Hafey. Well, what a day the Richmond side have had here this afternoon, Butch and Wes. There's John Nicholls, the disappointed captain and coach of the Carlton Football Club. As you see, Tom Hafey running out onto the ground to receive his players after a sensational victory in the grand final. They won the under-19 premiership this morning here. They won the reserve 18 premiership. And now they've won the senior premiership here at the MCG. Look at Tom Hafey, the very excited, jubilant coach of the Richmond Football Club. What a tremendous feeling must be for him. Tommy Hafey. And the final scores here in the grand final for 73. Richmond, 16-20, 100. successful team, Tommy Hafey and his Richmond players, have won the premiership, and what a year they have had.